live. We are so excited. We're back together. Nancy was on a news story. She'll be back in a few minutes. We are coming to you live from the Gardner School in Oak Brook. We have such an exciting show planned for you, and welcome to Chicagonista Live. We are so excited, like I said, to be broadcasting live from the Gardner School, the new location that's opening up in Oak Brook. It is just so amazing. And we have the regional director going to be talking to us, and the director of this facility talking to us, and a bunch of moms are here today to be talking to us. And this is a award-winning, academically focused preschool, and I believe it's from 6 weeks all the way through kindergarten. It's very exciting. We have so much information. We want you to tweet along with us today. We have some great prizes.
We have some great prizes.
Yeah.
$50 gift certificate from DuPage Museum, right?
Yeah.
Children's Museum. And we're giving like three today. So keep tweeting along. Hashtag Chicagonista Live. Hashtag Gardner Chai. And you can also add Gardner underscore Chicago.
Yes.
Gardner School, and keep continuing because we have a lot of great information for you guys.
And we're just so excited. It's been so long since we've been together. MJ's back from Asia. I went
World
to Europe.
Tour.
I'm sorry.
Jealous.
David just got his master's degree. Has just been so busy. I can't wait to catch up. And Nancy, of course, was called out on a news story, and she's going to come in here at any moment. And she has so much to share with us. But welcome. Oh my gosh, I forgot I brought gifts for everybody, but oh, left them in the car. Got them afterwards.
After the show.
A lot of things happening in Chicago, right? I mean, great, exciting stuff. Did you guys hear about James Beard Foundation? It's the event is now happening in Chicago. It's being moved to Chicago.
Oh, wow.
And it used to be from New York, which is 24 years. Has been going on in New York. And obviously Chicago has been the culinary center. And I mean, we have Trotter, who was one of the James Beard winner. I mean, there's so many of these great chefs are in Chicago. So very exciting that we have Nancy walking in. You're late.
This is live television.
This is real live television.
We need Nancy, and we're going to get Nancy a shirt, not that you need it, and some water. Would you like some water?
No, I'm okay. And I love that we're focusing on education, early education. I am just here from Oakland High School, where 47 kids are not being allowed to walk in graduation.
Why? Tell us.
Because they're required to do community service hours, and 47 of them decided to get a forged signature on their sheets. So they turned in sheets with a forged signature. None of them did service hours.
Just say no, kids, to a lot of different things.
I love the story so I can show my kid, because there are many times.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna stay, but I've signed a couple of things that they really did it. But
you know what?
Gotta watch
well, what
it.
What happened? Like, how did they get caught?
One child I talked with, he's the son of a single mother. He had to work sometimes 40 hours a week, and I can understand that, but it's a requirement of 24 service hours over 4 years of high school. And the threshold is fairly low, and the rules are the rules, and they never raise the flag.
So what's going to happen? Are they summer schooling? Or?
They will have to do the hours and prove it by the end of this month in order to get their diploma.
Wow.
But none of them will walk with their classmates tomorrow. It's
wow.
Sad.
How many kids again?
But 48.
Wow.
Because one was the ringleader who actually did the service hours. And he worked at the place where they supposedly did their hours,
wow.
But none of them had actually
apologize.
So again, moral of the story, be leaders, not followers.
I have a question though, I'm so curious. What counts as a service hour?
Well, working as, you know, daycare. I mean, you can come in and maybe help scrub floors here. Although this place is like spick
and span. It's a
mess. It's like a giant floor.
There's no kids here yet.
It's gorgeous.
There it goes. Yeah.
Yeah. Charming. Gorgeous here. But, you know, it could be anything. You could go help an elderly neighbor. Yeah. Anything.
Pick up trash.
But it's just learning to give back.
Is this a public school or a private school?
Oakland is a public
school. Oakland is a public high school.
Oh, so was it just for that school, not like a district?
It's just that
qualification.
School.
Yeah.
Wow. And it's just one student who apparently charged $20 per student get a signature.
A young entrepreneur.
But now he has to pay a bill. He's going to have to pay them back, right? Those students? Or what's going to happen?
Yeah, what's going to happen?
Gosh, they've got bigger problems.
Oh, kidding. That's devastating. Yeah. I have a son who's graduating.
It's sad all around.
That's scary.
But that's a lesson for you older kids. But
only
you
know, on Chicagonista Live are you going to get something
breaking
out of the
news.
Crowd.
Breaking news.
Fantastic.
But you know, it falls into general education and parenting altogether. And just, you know, a background, you know, this is a fabulous stepping stone into, you know, integrity and
absolutely.
Honesty.
All begins here.
Yeah. But a fascinating story to cover. I mean, and sad.
Wow.
It's amazing. But you're here just in time because we actually had a question for you.
Which was?
Well, we were going to talk about the Chicago parking app that you love so much.
Oh, it's Park Chicago. You have to download it. Right now, it is only for the West Loop. There are only slots allotted in the West Loop, but it allows you to feed your parking meter through the app. And
awesome.
It will send you a text message when you're 10 minutes away.
Wow.
So it'll say 10 minutes, do you want to feed it or do you want to go out?
That's so nice.
Do you know how long you can leave your car?
I think you can go indefinitely. As
Wow.
long as you're not over 2 hours, it's worth doing it. The 35-cent convenience fee.
That's what
if you're going to park over 2 hours,
35 cents.
Got another $50 ticket.
Yeah, I know. I mean, how many times have you run to feed a meter and like sweat?
Not only that, sometimes you're parking and the meter is like so far away.
Yes.
And it's like.
And you know what?
Who's got the quarters?
I use a
quarters anymore. The city.
I
know that.
I'm a 72 for an
Do they make quarters anymore?
I'm just
asking.
What's a quarter? It's an exception.
I'm old school.
No. Is it, I'm wondering, because I love that Chicago has so many startups.
Yes.
Is it a Chicago startup, perhaps?
I believe
so. That would be cool. Don't quote us.
Although, you know, Milwaukee beat us to this.
Oh.
Yeah.
Now, is this the same company that actually built those meters that everyone hates?
I believe so.
I wonder.
All
you know?
I know is it's awfully convenient and it's about
that's
a direct deposit.
Exactly.
Yeah. Right?
Well, you gotta be careful with the timing though, because I use a parking garage, and you know, I'm paying like more than half price sometimes when I park down there. But if you don't come back on time, you will get charged for later. Like I'm like,
she
man.
Knows that lesson. Oh. She pays like $45 a day because she's not feeding a meter.
Oh, and then I once parked at a meter and I came back and I had two tickets at my car. And I remember like calling and yelling at FJ, it wasn't her fault. I'm like, I have two tickets. You know what the tickets were for? I drive a car from Milwaukee, and they don't require front plates in Milwaukee. So I got a ticket for not having a front plate. And I got a ticket for being too far away from the curb, so it wasn't even a ticket for not paying.
Oh my God!
Two tickets, I'm like,
Beth rolled an app.
I know.
They just wrapped in tickets. I mean, like crazy.
Again, we are here at the Gardner School, so we're hashtagging Chicagonista Live, hashtag Gardner Chai, and we wanted to talk, this is a beautiful place. I know Nancy hasn't had a chance to look around, but we're here in the lobby right now, so beautiful. We had a blogger immersion day, 2 weeks ago, in a different location, but this is completely the same kind of cutout of the place. It's a lot brighter in here, it's different, but they're both beautiful. And their program, their early education
Can
program.
I go to school here?
I know! I want to have more kids just because of the school.
I really asked if I could work here, but I need a teaching certificate.
We can be five-year-olds.
Wait, the director here, Jennifer Farmer, who's going to be here today, she has her kids, two kids?
Mm-hmm.
two kids here, and she works here. How perfect is that?
Wow. I love
that. I wish I had that opportunity then. But we had our bloggers come and visit, and they looked around. They had a chance to be with their children and watch them. We have our first video right now with Jen Luby of SecondCitySoiree.com, and here is the video.
I'm Jen Luby. This is Sloane. She is 9 months. She's my only child, and my blog is SecondCitySoiree.com. Sloane had a great time playing with the other crawlers. She made a few friends. She almost sat on somebody else's lap, another baby, which was kind of funny, and she had a great time playing with the toys. I really enjoyed looking at all the different classrooms. Everything is divided up so nicely by age and by interest, and everything is just really bright and cheerful, and the uniforms are super cute. We had a great time today. She is a little tired. It was an eventful day, so I'm sure she'll have very sweet dreams in the car ride home.
Wow, that was fun. Jen Lee had that 9-month-old baby, and she was like so fast. I mean, it feels like she just had a baby yesterday, and she had fun bringing her baby here.
And you're going to get to meet the moms a little bit later on, because David's going to do an interview with the moms, and the kids are back. But welcome, Jennifer Farmer.
Thank you.
You are the executive director of this school that's getting ready to open.
Correct, yes. Yes, we'll be opening very soon, so we're excited.
Does it differ from any of the other locations?
Because we're a corporate office, all of our standards, our curriculum, everything like that is pretty standard among all of our schools. All of the suburb schools have a very similar design, and then our schools in the city are usually built in pre-existing buildings, and they have a little bit more of an urban feel. So they're similar pretty much across the board, especially in the suburbs as far as the way that they look and things like that.
I have to say, once you walk in, it's such a different feeling. I mean, you don't think preschool.
We try to make it feel more like an extension of the home, because we have children who are here, you know, for long periods of time throughout the day, and you know, we have a definite learning environment and a learning feel in all of the classrooms. But we also want to make it, we have very young children here, we want to make it feel comfortable and feel like a warm environment to come to every day. So I think the decor helps with that.
Wow. It's more than daycare. I mean, you take in 6 weeks to 5 years old. It's way more than daycare, I take it.
It is, yeah. And, you know, there's a lot of elements that parents are looking for when they're choosing a child care provider or for a preschool, from the location to the curriculum to the you know, feel of the school and things like that. But I'd say the number one trumping factor is the teacher, because that's who's in, you know, going to be nurturing your child, teaching your child, almost like another parent. Yeah. And so our teachers are really our most important asset here at the school, and that's why here at the Gardner School, we all of our lead teachers have a 4-year degree, and that's really something that sets us apart. And you know, as a parent myself, that just puts it in a whole different class of preschool, since that's the person in the classroom with the children.
Are they required to have a teaching certificate as well?
For the kindergarten, our teachers are required to have the teaching certificate. Okay. The other teachers, their 4-year degree just has to be related to the field. So some of our teachers have a degree in early childhood, some are in child and family studies, some are in child development. So it's always within the early childhood field, but it varies among the teachers.
Awesome.
And I wanted to bring up about the school. You walk in here, I loved how you said it's like a hotel, and it's very homey. And the classrooms are set up so unique and different, but also gives you the feeling that when the kids transition from here, they're going to understand what it's like to be in a classroom. But they're set up, can you tell us a little bit about how they're broken up by age groups? We were really impressed with that, and age-appropriate activities and toys and all of that as you go through, if your baby starts even at 5 weeks.
Yeah. So our infant rooms, look a lot like a nursery. You know, there are individual cribs for each of the children with lots of play space and soft spaces for them to play. And then when they finally get to be big kids in the toddler room, that transition happens at 15 months. So, you know, pretty much most children are walking at that point. They're a little bit more into a daily routine. So it looks a lot like a classroom, but it's everything's very miniature. The chairs are very low to the ground.
As I discovered.
Yeah. Please don't try to sit in them. So everything's very miniature at that age. And then once children turn two, they're in a new classroom, kind of 24
to 36. What is the average size
of the class? It really depends on the age group because the ratios change so greatly as the children get older. So obviously we have much smaller classes for our younger children. So infants, we have up to 8 children in the classroom, 10 once they're toddlers, and then it jumps to 16 once they turn 2. So that increases as the children get older.
One of the things that really impressed me, and I know we'll talk to Rochelle a little bit later about this, but when we were here, nap time happened. And I think it's such good peer pressure if you have a kid that doesn't nap and it's nap time.
I love nap.
It was so cute because the little cots were out and all the kids were napping and laying down and settled. And so the way that was structured in the day, and they had the cots there for the different age kids, was really...
Yeah, it's all about routine too. You know, school brings a lot of routine into a child's day, and they crave that, and it really helps them know what to expect. And you know, we have parents who sometimes don't believe their children that can nap because they can't get them to nap at home, and they'll come and look at our our screens where you can see into the classroom and the child can't see you, and they're like, oh my gosh, my child.
One other thing,
I love those nap times. My kids were all nappers. I mean, twice a day up until at least
kindergarten.
I loved it.
One other thing I loved that just stuck out in my mind was we came in, and I think it was the toddlers and the twos, and they were finger painting with green paint. Mm-hmm. And they were covered head to toe in green paint painting, and it was so cute. And it's nothing like you would let your kids do at home. But not only were they painting, but the social interaction of the kids all kind of helping each other. I mean, you don't get that at home. It's such a great learning and social.
But I'm amazed how they have all the paint here, but nothing on their table. It really did.
The other thing that impressed me was the outside area. Do you have that at this school too? So they all had like these little bikes and things they could... So talk a little bit about your outdoor space, because they don't have to go anywhere. It's right here.
Yeah, we have a really nice, we have kind of a hybrid space where we have an indoor play area that's kind of a gross motor room for when the weather's poor, and you know, this past winter in Chicago.
Which is a lot.
We were so glad to have it, so that we have a lot of space for the children to go. They do go outside twice a day, in the morning and again in the afternoon. But the indoor play space has big glass garage doors, so it's a lot of light in there, and then on nice days we just lit those up, and then the children can go in and out, have access to the bikes and the balls and all of those fun toys that we have in there for them. And then we do have two separate developmentally appropriate playgrounds. So one's for smaller children with smaller equipment, and then there's a second one for the 3, 4, and 5-year-olds so that it has larger equipment. And then they're separated by a fence so that we can go out and utilize that space to classes.
So I understand you guys have summer kindergarten boot camp. What does that mean?
We do, yeah. So,
no, I do a workout.
I don't think it's the same thing. I'm imagining a whole different boot camp.
Yeah, so we do have a summer camp through the whole summer for all age groups, but the summer boot camp for our pre-kindergartners kind of is integrated into that, and it starts about a month before the children go back to school. And so it just is extra work kind of in small groups on kindergarten readiness skills. Mm-hmm. So the children will work on sight words, phonics, handwriting, math skills, all of that kind of thing, and it ends the week before they go back. So it kind of gears them up to get back to school.
So this is not year-round?
The boot camp is not year-round. It's just right before they go to school. But we are a year-round school.
Wow.
So
okay, that's
throughout the year.
Mm-hmm. That's so fun. So we have another blogger video that we wanted to show you. Allison Bray.
Right, I wanted to thank you so much,
Jennifer,
for taking the time.
Of course, we're so glad to have you.
We want everybody to tweet along because we do have prizes that we're giving away too.
So we have $350 gift certificate to DuPage Children's Museum, so keep tweeting along.
Chicagonista Live,
Hashtag Gardner Child. Hash.
Thank you.
I don't think we're doing that.
That's
right.
A gate sign.
So here is Allison's Ray Blogger Day here.
Hi, I'm Allison Ray, and I have two kids, 6.5 and 4.5, and my website is sassymomsinthecity.com. What do we do here today?
We have lunch together.
And you got to meet other kids?
I got to meet other kids.
And some of the teachers. We had a lot of fun, didn't we? Ooh, what was your favorite part? Was it lunch?
Yeah.
Mine was seeing all the different classrooms and getting to see the facility of the Gardner School. Oh, I'd say the overall experience was very impressed. I mean, the facility is so clean and modern, and they have a lot of things like, I love the cameras in the waiting room in the lobby where the moms and parents can come in and watch their kids before or after school. I thought that was really interesting and unique, and the fact that they have an open door policy is really, really nice. I'd say my best parenting tip is ask for help. I always give my friends advice that you can't do it all alone. You need to ask for help, especially in the beginning. You either ask neighbors, your family members, your friends, because people need to know that you need help. It's hard in the beginning.
And welcome back to Chicagonista Live. I'm Dave Grotto, along with the rest of my Chicagonista pals here. And we're here at the Gardner School in Oak Brook, Illinois. And in fact, we're having a great time with the mommies who are in the mommy immersion that we did a little earlier, and with all these wonderful kids. How are you, kids?
Good.
Good. Right on cue, and I see someone's eating a cracker. Are you enjoying that chip?
Yeah.
Good. That's awesome. And we have Jen Luby here. Actually, Jen and I go back a ways, and congratulations on your baby.
Oh, thank you.
She is just, it's a she? Yes. I'm doing really good at identifying that. Having three daughters, I'm kind of intuitive about that. So this is awesome. Are you excited about the opening of the Gardner School?
It's beautiful. It's a gorgeous facility. I heard someone say earlier, maybe it was you. You said it looks like a hotel.
I actually tried checking in at the front counter. They said no MasterCard allowed.
Where's the concierge?
Exactly. Where's the concierge? And it's just gorgeous. And of course, you know, this is actually bringing back some memories of me and my children, and trying to find a great place that would be wonderful for them before they actually started the K-12 system. And this just looks like it has all the solutions. So tell me a little bit about what you're doing as a mommy blogger and then the immersion that you had.
Well, we had a great day here at the Naperville location. Sloan had a lot of fun in the baby room. She tasted all of the toys and decided that they were all delicious.
Are they good? That's a yes.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. So we had a great day. It's a beautiful facility and just so colorful and bright.
That's awesome. Great. And we know we have some other mommies back here. Who do we have back here?
Hello. Hi, I'm Samantha Schultz, and this is Jack.
Hi, Jack. How are you? Okay, that's all right. That's okay. And you are?
I'm Natasha Nichols, and the three other Afros belong to me.
And they're beautiful. Oh, wait, we have a hiding child. Who are you?
Charlie.
An honor and a pleasure to meet you. Are you guys having a great time here?
Are you having fun?
Now, is everybody enrolled here to go to the Gardner School? They're not, but you're thinking about it, though, right? Because I know they're having a membership drive or something, right?
She will be responsible for tuition.
Oh, she'll be responsible for tuition. That's awesome. That's great. So I'm sure as moms, you're probably thinking about, what are we going to do with the kids, and even before we get them into kindergarten? Have you found some of those kind of life decisions a challenge about what to do with kids?
I am almost 14 years in the parenting game. I actually have a child that's about to start high school next year, so I'm not as nervous as I was beforehand when he was this age. You just kind of figure out what to look for and see if your children have fun and respond well to the teachers and the environment that they're going to be in. And you kind of go from there. They're the leaders in it. And then, of course, my pocket is the second one. And if it all meshes well together, then we go forth from there.
Yeah, I think that's a really good point. You know, you have to have parent and child collaboration and seeing what really feels good to you. Absolutely. And what is your plan for Sloan when she becomes of age to go to school?
Well, it depends on where we're living, of course. It's important to have some place that's nearby. My husband has started to make rumblings about maybe moving to the suburbs. So.
Well, I live in the suburbs. It's okay, folks.
I grew up in the suburbs. It was okay then, too. we'll be
we
fine, I'm sure.
We have a consensus back here. The suburbs are okay.
Totally,
well, that's awesome.
Totally, yeah.
And that can change things.
Absolutely, absolutely. It's, you know, when you're living in the city, it's a little bit more of a game, although there are two Gardner schools. Hi there. There are two Gardners, two or three in the city, so that's certainly another option.
Yeah,
yeah.
That's great.
Lots to look for.
Well, if you come out to the western suburbs, you'll have yet another option here right in the Oakbrook location, which is absolutely gorgeous. You kids are doing terrific. I have to ask you, because I'm a dietitian by profession, what's your favorite food? Who wants to go first?
Okay.
I do. Okay. Go ahead. What do you think?
That's mine.
What's your food? What do you like to eat?
That is mine.
Anything that's his, I think was the translation. And that's kind of where I'm coming from with school. You know, if you see it, it's ownership. Right? That's what I kind of go with for it, too.
I like to eat blueberries and strawberries. And only pineapples.
And pineapples. And could you say for the record that I have not given you $20 to say that?
Well.
All right, I've been sold out by a child, you know, and the mouths of babes. So you heard it. Blueberries, strawberries, pineapple. That's fantastic. Who else has got favorite foods?
I like to eat macaroni and cheese.
Macaroni and cheese. Can you give me a high five on that one? There we go. How about yourself?
Grapes.
Grapes. Have you seen that video, Got Any Grapes? Right? And I know we're going to be talking a little bit later on about how important food is as part of this program, which is really exciting.
And I want to thank you all.
Thanks, ladies and kids. Let's give it up for the kids and ladies. Yeah, absolutely.
We're going to have links, or we probably do, to their blogs. And on their blogs, which all of you did such a nice job, are links to their videos that give you a little bit more into the insight of the Gardner School and the day that they had with their children here. Thank you all
nice.
So much.
Thanks, everybody.
We're actually planning on just leaving him here.
I'll give him some grapes. No, that was for that guy.
I'll come back when he's 18. Is that okay with everybody?
Thank you.
Really early education really is the backbone and the
foundation,
for the future. And it's such a huge decision, you know, what you decide to do for very early education.
And the funny thing I have to say is when Zachary came in here, because the Gardner schools have the same feel and the same layout, as soon as he got here, it was a different school. We did the immersion in the Naperville school, which was gorgeous. As soon as he got here, he knew the exact toy in the exact room where it was. And I think there's a sense of security and feeling. He already felt so comfortable here. So if you are a parent, Jen, like you, and you decide to start in the city and then move to the suburbs, I think it's such a great and easy transition for the child to already feel so confident and comfortable in the school. So I loved Zachary took my hand and he knew where he was going. So anyways, thank you so much, Mom.
Thank you, Mama.
Thank you.
You know, it's like being tired in Starbucks. And you know what you want and you're comfortable.
The Starbucks of child care. That's going to be the best choice.
Mention really quickly, and one of the things we noticed at the Gardner School as we were walking around was the equipment and the toys and the layouts of the rooms. And we had the fortune of being invited to a really great event. It was the first time it was held for an organization called Kids in Danger, and it was started here in Chicago, and it's a great resource for parents here in Chicago or around the nation. They're building the largest database. So if you're going to grandma's house, and she's like, I found a great stroller on eBay, or here's a crib that I found at my neighbor's garage sale, how do you know if that's safe? So kidsindanger.org has put together a database that you can go and search.
Wow.
Secondhand items. I wish we had this when we had the babies because really we didn't know much about, you know, we look for the cute stroller and the cute carrier.
It's like buying a car now.
Yeah. Right. I mean,
move roofs, 4x4.
No, but it's true. Maybe it's like the Carfax, right? Carfax for strollers.
It's a great idea.
But it's called Kids in Danger. It was started here in Chicago, and we're impressed with them because, like I said, you know, you go to Auntie's house and here's a stroller or crib that I bought. You want to make sure your kid is safe. So their mission is to promote the development of safer kids projects, and they've teamed up. I believe, or they're in the process with Booth School here in Chicago to innovate and create, have a team of people create safer children products for everybody. They're real advocates for children, so they're out there to advocate. And they're there to educate the public, especially parents and caregivers on the dangers. So in the future, we'll be doing a bigger interview with them, but really,
I think it's really important to know them and follow them along on Twitter. I saw that they're actually actively they just started a Twitter, but it's at kidsindanger.com. I mean, at kidsindanger on Twitter. And they pull out, you know, some great information for parents out there. So
that's where you can learn about
if before internet. What do we do?
We grew up.
We just trust people.
We weren't even in car seats. Just threw them in the back.
We were laying across the back window.
We would go on vacation. There's like four kids in the back seat, and then you've got the underneath. So a couple of us would fight underneath. No car seats. Give us a pillow and
Those were the days. Put shivers down our spine now if we saw that, right?
Oh, we saw them drive around.
I know. It was normal to have kids bouncing around the back seat.
This was the seatbelt, right? This was the seatbelt.
We had a good fight going all the way to the other side. Now the kids, like, you know, it's so good to have that resource. Yeah. I mean, really, I wish I had them when I was young.
Yeah, follow them on Twitter, or go to kidsindanger.org to get more information. But speaking about really raising your kids, as a parent, right, they brought up great points, like, how do you even know that the preschool where you're sending your kids, not only being a safe environment, but what really is the education? What are they learning there? What is happening when they're there? And so we want to bring on our next guest, who is such a wealth of information. Her name is Rochelle, and who wants to attempt? Everybody
go.
Cosnick.
The news reporter.
Awesome. Good job.
Thank you. Thank you so much for being with us. And we are so impressed with the Gardner School system. And tell us, does the curriculum change year to year? I mean, are there trends in early education?
Well, there's always trends, and we want to, at the Gardner School, always be on top of the trends. I mean, some of the things that we're also looking at, just even our communication. We're going more digitally and things like that. We're looking into different options
right now. Kids are learning much younger.
Absolutely. Oh. And they're so much more knowledgeable than we are at our age.
Yeah.
And they are just quick learners. And that's what's really great about early education, because we are readying them for school here at the Gardner School.
I assume that you do not allow iPads or iPhones into your, because so often we see 2 and 3 year olds, you know,
it's a babysitter. This is the new babysitter, right?
Well, it is, and we do have those on occasion in the classroom, but they're very supervised by the teachers. They are only used once in a while. Mm-hmm. We're doing, you know, playing through learning and our curriculum. There's so many things that are so hands-on that readies the whole child and getting them ready for school. So we don't use that because that's not something of great importance for early education.
The five-year-olds could be the head of IT here.
Absolutely, they can get all the technical stuff taken care of for us. They're very knowledgeable.
What I hear. Do you feel that parents have different demands these days compared
to very different. I mean, and that's one of the things at the Gardner School. We're very, very flexible. We want to meet the needs and build the relationships. Like Jen had mentioned, you know, we're a family. We are just kind of a community, you know, here in the community, we are your family, and we want to be a part of. When you come into our school, you feel very much at home. The children, like you said, when he walked in, he felt so comfortable. He knew exactly which classroom to go to and how comfortable, because the routines are very similar. And that's what's nice for children, because the parents feel safe. We have a very nice security system that we set up here at the Gardner School. They're secure to get in the front door. There's somebody at our front area, like you said, at the hotel, greeting you, which is great. And then we also have a system where the parents have to have a special code to get in. So they're just assigned. So there's two steps to security, and that's really important for parents nowadays. Is security is so, you know, on the thought of our mind.
And I love how you have those cameras.
Yes,
and that's unlike hotel rooms. You talk about that, but I love that.
You're Jay-Z and Beyonce.
Is we do have a live feed, so when the parents come in, because you know sometimes at separation time when they're leaving in the morning, the moms and dads are feeling hard about leaving, right. And the drop off is very tough. I mean, it's cheerful for all of us. So we help them by having the cameras in the classrooms, that because they know then they come out here to our front foyer area, plug into their classroom, see live what's happening in the classroom, and then they can see, oh, look at, he's already engaged, already in the class. The teachers went over, comfort him. You know, that at the Gardner School with our lead teachers, they're always there. They know the right thing because they've specialized in the education of that.
Do you think the whole term helicopter parent, is it getting, are parents easing off? Are they becoming more so helicopter? I mean, I feel like we were, you know, pretty much all of our kids, and we're so on top of things. Do you think it's worsened, or is it easy?
I don't want to say it's worsened, but you know what? Our children are our most precious
item.
It's
true.
And you know what? They're our investment in life and everything, and we take them. They're so special to us, and we here too feel that that relationship, so it's not that the parents are asking us anything unusual, it's what's best for the child, because if that's always the first thing that we think of, what is best for that child, that will be the right answer, because that's the key, is what's best for that child.
I wanted to ask you, so how do parents know what their child's doing during the day? What is the communication between Gardner and the parent? So you know what little Jimmy did today at school type of thing. How do they find
out? So an example is, as they come into the school, at the Gardner School, they come in at the end of the night. Well, even in before in the day when they drop off as an infant, they have a paperwork that they can fill out and say, this is what happened last night. She was a little fussy. The baby wasn't sleeping all that well. So the teachers kind of know a heads up what's happening for the day and what they should be looking for. So that kind of helps them through the day. And if there's something that, gosh, they're just not acting right, we have phones in the classroom. The parents can call directly into the classroom, have that communication right there so that they know exactly what's happening. We don't want them to be worrying. We tell them, please give us a call. We want you to call. We want you to feel comfortable. Because if you're at your work thinking about that, you're not there. You're not focused on your job, and you're not doing the best thing for your job, and we're not also, then it's helping the child
too. Well, I think with parents being away and, you know, having that comfort of just being able to be in touch throughout the day and know that they're fine.
And any communication, we like that. And then also at the end of the night, too, as they come in, we hand them a daily sheet so that every age group, from the 6 weeks up to the 5 years, they get a daily sheet and they know exactly what's happened for the day. What they ate, what time they had, what they did in interaction. There's some cute things that maybe go through the day that one of the kids said to the other friend. Aww. And it's a nice thing that on the car ride home, you can say, oh, did you talk about this in the book? Or what were you, kind of giving the parents some key things to ask them, like, what did we study today? What was the letter we focused on? What was this? And gives them some good communication to keep that open line of communication for the families at home.
I want high school teachers to.
I know.
I'm 20 to 19 days.
child by the Gardner School is going to spoil the parents by the time they get into regular school. They're going to be like, what?
We're readying them for that.
We have an adult daycare system. Wow.
Is there proof of performance, a track record? I mean, is there proof that, you know, kids who have gone through this system do better?
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, you know, our corporate office is out of Nashville, and you know, just a tiny little fact, some of our kids that graduate, which we're coming up on spring flame graduation right now, the kids are going through graduation, kindergarten graduation, which is so cute because they do the whole pomp and circumstance and everything. They have a whole program. In fact, I'm going to one tonight at what our Naperville school is hosting one, and they do that, and like those kids that are ready, they can recognize up to 100 sight words heading off into kindergarten.
That's
a big step, and that's for a five-year-old getting them ready for kindergarten, so we really are readying them for that.
That's great.
Wow. Right.
Yeah, I have here 40-year-olds who received early education earn on an average of 33% more annual income than those who did not. So
it does help, early education.
Well, the school is great, and we thank you so much. Are there any words of wisdom you want to leave us with?
No, we're just very blessed that you guys could come here and share with us, and we're very excited to be here in the Chicago market. It's very exciting for us, and we're really happy that we're here, and thank you so much.
Thanks for having us. Thank you. It's really
great. Are we looking at opening again?
Well, we're looking sometime in June here in this one in Oprah. We just had licensing here, so very successful.
Two things I want to... really quick that also impressed me because it's so much. I love that you do like a parents get together like twice a year. You said that the parents can do like a date night or a night out, and they can drop the kids here where they feel confident, because a lot of parents will leave their kids with anybody for the first couple of years, and you offer that here.
Yeah,
I believe. And I also love that you also encourage the parents to kind of engage with each other so they can meet each other, and I think there were some activities or something.
We do fall festival, and we do lots of things, and we do events that the parents get together, because just like in the city and out in the suburbs, it's nice to have play groups and get to know each other's children's friends, and then the parents do get to have communication time. They can set up parties, birthday parties, fun things together.
Another question, because I forgot to completely ask you. I'm a dietitian. So one of the things that I found interesting as I looked in there, looking at all the great food that's set up. So talk to me a little bit about the philosophy of food and fueling the minds and bodies of these children.
Well, we want it always to be healthy, and all, you know, because we are licensed through the state, we have a requirement to meet the dietitian and the dietetic needs of everyone. And that's what's nice too, is we at the Gardner School try and have as much, you know, fresh fruit and fresh vegetables, and also having a menu plan that's kid friendly.
Nice.
You know, that is key, because we want them to eat. And the thing too is getting them to try it. Because if they're sitting down with their peers and somebody goes, oh, I don't want broccoli, and then if you say, oh, taste it, have a bite, taste it. Oh, look at Tommy's eating it. Why don't you taste it and see? The encouragement, that peer pressure kind of helps too. So they do like to taste and get
that. That's great.
Thank you for welcoming us into your home.
Yes, it is.
And I have a hotel. I think David might
know.
The time is checkup.
In our home, it's always a home.
Well, very homey. Very.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you so much.
You know, the exciting part is this place is not even open yet. So you guys at home, you're seeing it where no one has seen it. Us first and then you guys. But the cool part too is we have another blogger during immersion day who got to go around and check out. And you met her earlier, Natasha Nichols. So this is her video.
My name is Natasha Nichols. My blog is House Full of Nichols. I have four children, ages 13, 5, and a set of 3-year-old twins. My three youngest children and I took a tour of the Gardner School, and we were able to see all of the classrooms that they have for each grade level and how much that they would enjoy for each of their ages. Nap time for me would be the favorite part. But I think their favorite part would be the centers or anything having to do with art or creative play. My overall experience today was, I think this would be a very great school
for any child to come to. And it's a bonus because they start at 6 weeks and they literally follow you or follow your child until they're 6 years of age. Don't sweat the small stuff. Literally laugh a lot. You know, you only get children once, and if you don't enjoy them while they're children, then you really, really miss an integral part of being a parent.
So what I think is really cool, oh, stop talking over me. You miss all the good chatter between the commercials or between the things. Anyways, what's really exciting is we've been able to see Gardner School with the mom bloggers and their immersion videos, and thank you for our crew and Rudy and everybody for doing such a great job.
Yay.
But there's another video I can't wait to show you. Actually, our very own MJ Tam, who did her whole tour of Asia, had the opportunity to go to a school to meet teachers and students. Why don't you tell us a little bit about the video?
As you know, you guys are probably so sick about hearing about
that. No, we're not.
But I took that whole month tour with DoubleTree, and one of the things that I really love the part is how many tourists ever go visit a school when when you're visiting another country. But I had an opportunity. They have this program called Cookie Care, where they're giving cookies to make everyone smile, but there has to have a purpose. And the great part about Malaysia is they figured this is great. We should go to the school, visit the school children, hand them cookies, and so they can hand it to their teachers as thank you. So it's a wonderful event that we did, and it's like 1,200 kids that showed up, and this is only fifth and sixth graders. Wow. And then DoubleTree came here to Chicago, and because 100 years of the Wrigley Field came along, Beth came with me, and everybody was, it was like last minute thing, and I know you were watching.
I was inside. She was inside.
But we were able to hand out cookies everywhere outside the Wrigley Field, and here's a video of Cookie Care in Chicago showing a little bit of Malaysia. From Malaysia, I did a cookie care there where we're giving cookies to little kids to give to their teachers as thank you. Now we're here in Chicago, and we wanted to introduce to you Maggie Giddens of DoubleTree. We
have something really special about the cookie care cookies that we're giving away today. Can you tell me what that is?
Sure. Well, traditionally in our hotels, we give a warm chocolate chip with Juana's cookie to our guests as they check in, and this is sort of an expression of our care culture, which every DoubleTree by Hilton hotel in the world participates in. And today, we're actually, we know that it feels really good to us when we're giving away these cookies. So today we're actually giving away two, one for the person who's taking it and one for them to share, so that other people can have that warm feeling that you get when you share a little piece of cookie care.
It was really exciting to watch you participate with the cookie care in Malaysia. It's really all over the world. But let's talk a little bit about MJ's relationship with DoubleTree.
Yeah, we just want to thank you so much, MJ. You've been a fantastic detourist all around Asia where you were traveling, and we look forward to your updates every day. It's so good to be on your turf now and experience your hometown.
My hometown. Yeah.
Spreading the cookie care here. So just thank you for everything you've done, and it's been a blast.
Why cookie care, and what does care really mean to you, DoubleTree?
Absolutely. So DoubleTree by Hilton has a culture called care, which is all about creating a rewarding experience for our team members, for our hotel guests, as well as for the communities where we are located. So the idea of cookie care really ties in that cookie that is our icon, the symbol of DoubleTree in our hospitality, but then also connects it with our culture. As we're creating a rewarding experience for our guests when they arrive at the hotels and we get to present that cookie, we want them now to have that same experience out on the streets and get two cookies, one for them to keep and enjoy, and then one for them to share and extend that idea of creating a rewarding experience for somebody else.
Well, speaking of kindergarten, when I first came to America, I went right into kindergarten, and some of the amazing classmates and their moms were homeroom moms and would come and do flashcards with me so that I could learn English. Well, there are some new apps now that our kids, your kids, are growing up in the digital age. I mean, I'd love to see them use flashcards still, but wouldn't it be cool if they were just to keep them busy? I mean, sometimes, you know, keep them not only busy, but educated. There's this iTot app where they can learn shapes, like for example.
Diamond. That's an important one.
It's called iTot.
It's called iTot, and it's just a quick flashcard, but it's digital flashcard.
Fantastic. And it's free. You know, we're into free.
Yeah, it's free.
And it comes. You can set it in different languages. So I
was
could you make it? You have to buy to use the other languages.
I think
you get one.
I'm learning English.
And then I'm learning English.
But another cool app is, you know, remember what Sketch and Etch?
Or Etch a Sketch.
Remember?
Right.
When we were younger, well, gosh, that was like the 70s or 80s, right? I don't know. It probably
was. Or 90s when I was
Or 60s. We believe that.
Here's another great app for kids. And, oh, I got a tweet.
That's not for kids.
No, but the Scribble Lite is a great app. You can set the backgrounds. So, like, I just picked my background to be red, or you can change to blue. And then you could, like, to sketch. The circles are different sizes, so you could actually. I'm going to show you here.
That's so cool.
So you can sketch right on your iPhone.
Yes.
For your phone.
Yes.
So this is probably great even for iPad, you can doodle.
Yeah.
And
yes. Yeah. So anyways.
Oh, and not that fun. Frozen is bad, but the fact is that the fact that it could be on the iPad or your phone and doing something that's educational besides watching Frozen for the 400th time.
But it's such a good movie.
Oh, my daughter's one.
I haven't seen it. Am I the only person in the
room? You're missing out. It's so
it's
cool.
The most go together. Popular princess. I
but I
all
it's
like
good.
The most
let it go already.
Alright, we gotta go.
And I'm looking over.
Those are great.
Yeah, those are great. And I always, when I'm with my little nieces and nephews, I'm amazed that these kids at this age, I mean, like Dave said, by the time they're five, you could probably hire them as IT.
I'm amazed at the stuff that they can teach me. I mean, even I am like pretty, you know, into the whole thing, but sometimes my son would come up with stuff, I'm like, oh, why didn't I think of that? I mean, really.
And there's so many more apps that Gardner recommended that we're going to post someplace. So you'll just keep watching Chicagonista Live, and we'll have a post.
Or check ChicagonistaLive.com.
Yep. ChicagonistaLive.com. We'll have Jennifer Farmer gave us this whole list of really great apps for your children. So we'll definitely have that up.
I wish I had this resource with my kids.
It's
been
goodness.
So great. First of all, to be in this beautiful location. Yeah. I actually told the Gardner School that I think we're going to do every show here from now on.
Look at this beautiful place.
It's so homey and it feels great.
Yeah. But keep on tweeting. If you guys haven't, don't stop because we still have to give prizes. Hashtag ChicagoNewsLive, hashtag GardnerChai. But I wanted to show you guys the next video. Samantha Schultz, she was here with the two little boy, cute little boys. And she was here as part of the Vlogger Immersion Day as well. So here is Samantha's video.
Hi, I'm Samantha Schultz and I blog over at the Peanuts Gang. I have two boys, Charlie and Jack, and Charlie's here with me today. He's five. So while the kids were playing and learning a little bit more about the school, we were learning and walking around and seeing a tour and getting a chance to see kind of kids in their element and see what the Gardner School offered. So I liked seeing how the school really encompasses the whole child from the meals to playtime to learning. It really gives students an opportunity to really develop their world and see what's around them. And I just really thought they encompassed that great. And being able to see the school and seeing it in action was awesome. Personally, I thought it was a great opportunity. I have one child who's already in preschool and another one who is going to be entering preschool, and being able to see the experiences that they offer to children was amazing. I think they really truly encompass and understand children, and the fact that they have staff that's certified, that has gone to college, is really impressive to me. And I think that they really hit the nail on the head when it comes to the room decor and the overall setting of the school. It's calming, soothing, and as a parent, I appreciate that immensely. I think my best parenting tip is to get sleep when you can and play with them because they're only little for so long.
Wow.
Well, that was Samantha and her two boys are just like the cutest. They were so excited to get here today.
Aww. Come out and see the school. There's so many here in the Chicago area. Just go online and find one and go see it. You'll thank us.
Wait a minute. I missed the... Did
oh,
I miss
oh, shoot. Oh. Oh, my gosh.
Did I miss that?
Yes.
Oh, my gosh.
They have uniforms. They're what age?
Three years old?
That is
what
adorable.
Age do they start wearing the uniforms?
Three years old. How cute
they
is that?
They have the cutest uniforms. I forgot. I wanted to find out if it came in my size.
I know I'm only
that's the girls, right?
Beautiful. That is so darn cute.
My daughters would love this.
So the boys look like a khaki and
so cute. Come just ask to see the uniforms. I have to say hi to real quick before we go. We have a couple minutes left. Auntie Judy watching us in Florida. Shout out.
She's always watching us.
Always watching us.
Hi Judy.
See Judy. You're speaking.
Oh yes. June 30th, which is Social Media Day around the world, here in Chicago, we will be selecting the Social Media Person of the Year for 2014.
Because, you know who the Social Media Person of the Year last year? Of course, Nancy Lou.
For some reason,
and, you know, there's like four choices here.
You never know.
So is this like a voting process?
It's the former winners along with the...
How many winners are there?
There are three so far. Mm-hmm. Because social media is a pretty new game everywhere.
And this is June 30th, right?
Yeah, so June 30th here in Chicago and around the world. It's a national day.
It's big.
So
that's how we met. Yeah. We all met through social media.
On Twitter, I think.
Before we saw each other in real life.
Before we knew I was a stalker.
First time I met you was in an airplane. You remember that?
Oh my gosh!
And it was in the bathroom. I don't know how we did it. Oh no.
I think we saw David on Facebook.
I walked in the airplane, I knew it was David Brado. We were doing something for California Strawberry.
That's right.
I walked in, I'm like, oh, David.
He said he was tall and wearing red.
But he's tall. I mean, I'm standing and he's sitting down. We're the same level, so that must be David.
I'm thinking about applying for the Guinness Book of World Records to be the tallest registered dietitian in the world. I don't know if that's necessarily true, but I might be in the
wrong. You never know.
So I'm going to create my own award.
Yeah.
That's why he likes hanging around with us, because he's even taller when he's...
And we have one minute. Zach, come in. My son flew in from New York.
Speaking around the world, in New York, and, kids all over the world.
And he works, and he makes these really cool wallets with this guy who's a local guy. Called, what are they called, Zach? Keep it tight?
Tight wallet.
And, tight wallet.
And everything goes in it, your money, your cards, and it goes in your pocket.
Awesome. Hey, that's a great idea.
Look at that.
Yeah,
okay, wait. This is
your
wallet.
Phone and your money can go together.
Yeah. It's for next time. We'll talk about it, but I just wanted to give it a...
What a great idea.
My friend
created these.
Jack, yeah, from Lake Zurich. But
Chicago guy, but they work in Brooklyn together.
You can use it as like a finger warmer or whatever you want.
Don't get David started. Anyways, we want to thank the Gardner School. Thanks, Zach. For hosting us today. All of the great information.
So cool.
Hosting the mom bloggers. Letting David show up. No.
And Zach.
And Zach. And everybody. What else is...
And we're going to mention the winners. I know Duana's working on that, and Midori. We have a lot of new interns that just came here today. We wanted to say Matthew, Midori's here. We have a couple more that we want to say. Monica's around here as well. So thank you so much.
And our crew.
And
there's so much on tap for this summer. So you want to join us for our Chicagonista Live in June.
In June.
You know, the kids will be out of school and it'll
finally
be a regroup.
That weather out there, it's actually really almost June. I mean,
it's
been so wintry.
We've been waiting for this day. Oh my gosh.
Palmer's Armin Eckes says, recommending that we're going to have, probably not recommending, they're suggesting we're going to have the hottest summer.
Oh my gosh,
really?
That's so much for Chicago.
Oh my gosh, do you remember a couple summers ago? It was like 107
in Chicago.
Oh yeah, it's
crazy. Welcome back.
Okay, well, I'd rather take the heat than the cold.
All right. And congratulations again to our own dear.
Yay!
Oh.
Congratulations to you. You must have done community service first.
That was part of my degree. Well, it's great, and I'm excited because I'm actually going to be giving back to Chicago. I was offered a teaching position at the University of Illinois Chicago to teach entrepreneurship. Go figure.
Oh, wow.
Absolutely. Awesome. Absolutely. Mama didn't raise no dummy. That's what I said.
Well, thank you, everybody. We'll see you guys again in June.
See you in June.
Thank you.
Thank you, Gardner School.
Bye.
Bye.